In this lesson, we will cover what each of the toolbar actions do. Some of these go further, are a little deeper. There's more that goes into each of these actions, and some of them are pretty simple to explain. This lesson will just cover the high level of what each of these button options do. So let me open up GitKraken. Let me close the terminal here. I kind of spoiled a little bit. But the first action that I'll cover are the undo and redo buttons. And these behave very similarly to other undo redo buttons you might be familiar with in, say, word processor applications. In this case, the undo button is really good at undoing any action that you perform locally on your machine with respect to your repository. So undo a branch checkout, undo a discard. What you will not be able to undo are any remote actions. So if you perform a merge on your remote, you're not going to be able to undo that. So there is a limit to what you can undo locally. You can undo a lot of things that you perform locally, but when it comes to remote actions, that's where you will find that you'll have to take different actions to resolve an undo, such as a revert commit, which we'll save for a future lesson. You can also redo. So in this case, I undid the discard, but you can also choose to redo a local action. So in this case, I will redo that discard. And so that's a nice way to, if you find that you're working on your repository and you need to go back on a decision, the undo and redo buttons are here to provide you that flexibility. Next, we have the pull button. So if you hit pull, it'll perform whichever action you have set as the default. So if you click this arrow icon next to the pull icon, this is where you can select the default pull or fetch operation that will happen when you click this button. And the way you set the default is that you just click this little radio button. So in this case, I'll switch it to fetch only. So now when I click this button, it will only perform a fetch, which downloads the changes but does not merge them into my local repo. So by default, the pull fast forward if possible option is checked. So, and then, but we do provide options to pull fast forward only or pull rebase. We will talk about what these options mean in a future video. Next, we have the push option. So push will push if your repo is connected to a remote hosting service, if you have a remote setup for this repo, that's where you will be able to push to whatever upstream you have connected. So in this case, this is a repo that is hosted on GitHub. I can push and it'll push up to the remote version of that branch, which is, and then you'll know that a branch exists on the remote if you see both the, in this case is the GitHub icon and also the local machine icon. Next we have the branch. So this will create a branch on whichever commit or branch you have checked out. So in that case, I had the main branch checked out, but if I check out this feature branch, I can then click the branch option and I can create the branch there. I can check out a commit. I'm jumping ahead a little bit, but just to kind of give you a preview, I can make this the head and then click branch, and then you can create your branch name here as well. Okay, let me undo that. Let me undo a little bit more. I want to have a whip, because next I'm going to show off the stash button. The stash button will create a stash for whatever you have in your whip. And fun fact, if you click into here, you can name your stash by typing here. So that's a great way of naming your stash. Hit the stash button, that will create the stash. We also give you the ability to pop the stash. So pop will delete the stash, but apply the changes from the stash to your whip. So there you go. We have that README file back in our whip. And then finally, we have the terminal button. So this will bring up the inline terminal. This behaves much like any other terminal you have on your machine, where you can run any number of commands. We do have some autocomplete available as a result of using the terminal tab, the terminal inside of GitKraken client. So for example, if you want to do git add, we'll provide you with some pretty convenient auto suggest and auto complete features. There's definitely more that goes into it, but we'll save that for a future lesson. But for now, you now have a good idea for what each of the major actions in the main toolbar do. The last thing I'll show you, but this will also be its own video, is that you can pull up the command palette. That's what this magic icon here in the top right does, which allows you to perform quick actions right from just typing in your keyboard. And then you also have the ability to search for commits. You can type, say, the word initial, and it'll highlight commits that match your result. All right, I think that's everything that's in the toolbar. I'll see you in the next video.